Ahmed Hassan.
Chairman, sir.
You have 8 minutes, please keep that in mind. You have 8 minutes, you have time, please keep that in mind, boss.
My time is, sir, 5 minutes.
You have 8 minutes.
8 minutes, all right.
Not five.
Thank you, sir. Chairman, sir, I'd like to thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak on this important and landmark bill. Sir, the National Commission for Backward Classes was set up under the National Commission for Backward Classes Act 1993. If we pass this bill today, the Commission will receive constitutional status. This is indeed an important moment in our constitutional history. Sir, it must be pointed out that this bill has gone back and forth between the two houses of parliament. When the bill was initially sent to this house, it was referred to a select committee. Sir, subsequently, this house returned the bill to the Lok Sabha with a few amendments. What we have received today from the lower house is the same version of the bill that was debated exactly a year back during the monsoon session of 2017. Sir, the Lok Sabha, in its wisdom, has not accepted suggestions that were made in this house regarding the composition of the panel. The minister, however, gave his word to the Lok Sabha that once the rules are framed, the inclusion of a woman member in the panel will be ensured. Sir, it is important to understand that, the need for such a representation. The unique perspective of women belonging to the backward classes is essential, as their experiences make them uniquely suitable to guide the panel on issues concerning women belonging to the backward classes, sir. I hope the minister delivers on his promise to the lower house. Sir, it must be pointed out that a major issue with the bill still remains. Last year, when the bill was debated in this house, my party had made it stand clear. We felt that the bill unduly interferes in the state rights. Sir, the bill gives power to the president to add to the list of backward classes for a given state after consulting the governor. My colleague, Mr. Sukhendu Shekhar Roy, had submitted a dissent note on the select committee. Our party believes that such a provision erodes the freedom, the federal structure of our polity. The bill seeks to create a commission that has sweeping powers and centralized authority. The language in the bill does not suggest that the president is bound by the advice given to him by the governor on inclusion of communities into the list of backward classes. The president is merely supposed to consult the governor. This undermines the role of state government. As pointed out by my party last time, sir, it is the state governments that have a closer role to play in the day-to-day lives of the people of this country. Implementation of schemes and provision of basic welfare services falls within the domain of the states. This places state governments in a unique position to understand the specific needs and aspiration of specific communities. Therefore, when one is speaking of the state list for backward classes, it must always be the sole prerogative of the state governments to add communities to this list. The commission at the national level shall not be as equipped as the states to understand these unique needs. Sir, we further believe that the requirement of consulting the commission on matters leading to the major policy matters affecting socially and economically backward classes must not be mandatory.
Must not be seen
when dealing with
reading.
the when dealing with the mayor,
keep the paper below.
Oh, when dealing with the Satnish, sir, under this government, there has been a creeping encroachment into the state rights, and this provision shall have the same effect. I ask the minister to consider this and clarify how states' rights in this important matter shall be preserved if this bill is passed.
I do commend this
bill for giving constitutional status to the National Commission for Backward Classes, but do place on record our reservations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. No,